Hello, my dear students. Good morning. Now we will continue class with acid dissociation constant. Okay, which is one of the important concept in ionic equilibrium. See here, HA is dissociating as H plus plus A minus. So HA is suppose it's a weak acid. What is this HA? HA is weak acid. So it cannot dissociate 100%. So how much it was dissociated, we will measure by using this acid dissociation constant with respect to dissociation, degree of dissociation alpha. Okay, so initially if you see here the concentration is C alpha, and initially there will be a 0, 0, and initially concentration is C, sorry, initial concentration is some C, and in C some percentage was dissociated, means this is the degree of dissociation. Suppose 40% dissociation happened from C. So 40% means alpha will be 0.4 we have taken. C alpha, and this is C alpha, and remaining C minus C alpha. Because HA only giving H plus and A minus. So C alpha will give C alpha and C alpha. So remaining is C minus C alpha concentration. Understanding? So as I said here, x and x means here 1 minus x like that. If you take 1 here, 1 minus x here, x and x you can take. When you can take x directly, particular quantity, if that particular acid or base is 100% dissociable. But this particular HA is a weak acid, it cannot dissociate 100%. So this much was dissociated from C. So that's why we use C alpha. So here, what is alpha? Alpha means degree of dissociation. What is alpha? Alpha means degree of dissociation actually. So this is very important. So if they said 60%, suppose example I am saying, example, if any particular acid HA 60% dissociated, then alpha is equals to 0.6. Okay? Simply, when the given percentage, you have to take percentage by 100, that will be alpha. So alpha you can take like this, alpha is equals to percentage given which was dissociated by 100. Suppose if a 9% dissociated, so 9 by 100, that is alpha in that way. So acid how much dissociate they will give, so they will ask what is Ka. Now equilibrium constant only Ka. So what is Ka now? Ka is equals to concentration of H plus into concentration of A minus by concentration of HA. This is Ka. Then Ka is equals to concentration of H plus at equilibrium how much? C alpha. Concentration of A minus? C alpha. By C minus C alpha. So concentration of HA is what at equilibrium? This is at equilibrium. C minus C alpha. Then what is Ka? Ka is equals to C square alpha square by C into 1 minus alpha. Can I write? C into 1 minus alpha. It's not C, bracket it is. Now C cancel. Then what you can write? Ka is equals to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. This is very, very important. So what is C? Initial concentration of this particular acid, or here acid we take. If you take base also same, C we will take as a base concentration. This is a Kf for a particular weak acid. This is Kf for, this is acid dissociation constant for weak acid. This one. Okay. If acid is very weak, otherwise, if acid dissociate very less. Acid dissociate very less, then alpha can be negligible. Alpha can be negligible in denominator. You can neglect this alpha, then what you can have, therefore Ka is equals to just C alpha square. This is for very weak acid, very much weak acid. That is when alpha is very small. When alpha is very small. This is Ka is equals to C alpha square. Then what is alpha? Alpha is equals to root Ka by C. Sir, alpha till how much we can take like this C alpha square instead of 1 minus alpha means if less than 10% you can take just Ka is equals to C alpha square. Less than 10% like the 9% is there. 0.09. So 1 minus 0.09 won't give much difference. So if alpha is less than 10% like that, then directly you can take Ka is equals to C alpha square. If they ask alpha by giving Ka and initial concentration, then alpha is equals to root Ka by C. Remember this formula. And one more important thing, what is the H plus concentration? By giving alpha, sometimes they will ask pH. At that time, we know, what we know, that concentration of H plus is equal to C alpha. What is alpha? Root Ka by C. So what you can write here, therefore I will write continuation here. Then concentration of H plus is equals to C into root Ka by C. Instead of alpha, I written root Ka by C. So therefore, what you have here, concentration of H plus is equals to root Ka into C. Root Ka into C. Concentration of H plus is equal to root Ka into C. That's it. So these are the relations actually. Alpha formula, Ka formula, H plus relation with what we call Ka. Okay. H plus why we are calculating? To know pH. If you know the concentration of H plus when they give an alpha, so that you can use this formula. What I am saying, understanding? They are asking pH by giving alpha and the initial concentration or something like that, or by giving degree of dissociation, acid dissociation constant, then first we will calculate concentration of H plus, then we will calculate pH like that. So this is one of the way to have pH also here. So what I written all formulas for weak acid, I write with respect to alpha. So you please have a look and go through this, and you have to write notes, that is very important. Only just you have to make a short notes, because in revision you are having all particular formulas here itself. So you can write, and me also will provide. Okay, thank you. And now we will write all formulas here. So what are the formulas here? Say what I written. First, Ka is equals to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. Otherwise, Ka is equals to C alpha square. And alpha is equals to root Ka by C. And concentration of H plus is equals to C alpha. And similar way, concentration of H plus is equals to root Ka into C. Like this. These are for whom? These are all formulas for whom? For weak acid. So the same kind of all formulas, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are all formulas we can write for weak base also. For weak base, we will write Kb, that's it. C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. And the second formula, this one. Kb is equals to C alpha square. And third formula, alpha is equals to root Kb by C. And fourth one, concentration of OH minus is equals to C alpha. And fifth one, concentration of OH minus is equals to root Kb into C, you can write. That's it. Got it clearly? Sir, how we come to know, sir? They will say weak base, then we use like this. By saying weak base, if they are asking pH, then first we have to calculate OH minus concentration, then we will calculate POH, then we will calculate pH. That is the way. Got it clearly? So these are the important formulas what we have. So here we have all formulas at one place actually now. Okay, so very, very important, sir. Please write it down. So based on this, you will have questions also. Okay, suppose they ask like this, calculate pH of some NH4OH, NH4OH, which dissociate up to up to some 10% like this. Okay, like this they give up to 10%, and okay, so given like this, and initial concentration of this particular, okay, initial concentration of NH4OH is some 0.01 like this. So that now you can calculate pH. Yes, how sir? Because concentration of OH minus is equals to C alpha. So what is C? This one, initial concentration 0.01. then what is alpha? 10 by 100. 10 by 100 means just 0.10 by 100, no? So 1 by 10, 0.1 alpha, correct sir? 10% is 0.1. okay, now what you will have, concentration of OH minus is equal to this one 0.01, that means 10 power minus 2, this is 0.1, that means 10 power minus 1, C alpha. That means concentration of OH minus, what you have, 10 power minus 3. That means what is POH? POH is equals to minus log concentration of OH minus to the base 10. Then what will be POH? I told you in previous, what the power you have, that is answer. Concentration of OH minus, or express whatever you have, 10 power something, that something is the answer. POH is minus log 10 power minus 3 to the base 10, that is 3. Then what is pH? It's 14 minus 3. So it's 11, answer pH. Sir, similar question. If they given, so please have a screenshot or pause the video and write down by using all those formulas. Same question, if they given like this. Note this one. Okay. Now, if they given dissociation constant instead of initial concentration, and dissociation constant of Mr. NH4OH is some 2 into 10 power minus 5 like this given. Then what we will do? Calculate pH only. Now dissociation constant for base, this is a weak base. That means what this is? Kb. Dissociation constant for weak base means Kb or not? So then concentration of OH minus, you have to consider this alpha given, alpha and Kb, any relation? First you can have like this, yeah, initial concentration also there. Then yeah, your concentration of OH minus is nothing but root Kb. Root Kb into C. Then instead of this alpha, degree of dissociation, and which has 0.1 m initial concentration, this is initial concentration given, then root Kb into C. If they given alpha and dissociation constant, I think probably you cannot calculate actually. Concentration of OH minus is C alpha. Otherwise Kb given means initial concentration is required. Alpha if you know, then what you can do? You cannot do anything. Then at least initial concentration is required. Okay. Then root Kb into C. Then this one is Kb is 2 into 10 power minus 5. Initial concentration 0.1. That means 10 power minus 1. So this is concentration of OH minus. Then concentration of OH minus will be, you can answer this, root 2 into, it's 10 power minus 3. Root 2 means everybody knows 1.414. So if you simplify, then you will get pH. Okay, pH you will have, sorry, first POH, sorry. First POH, again pH, as usual. So this is about acid dissociation constant for both weak acid and weak base with respect to what? Alpha. Okay, so now we will discuss about Mr. last and final concept, that is solubility product. Solubility product, we use KSP. Solubility product, direct formula I will give you. Remember, for any salt actually. Solubility for a product for a particular salt. What kind of salt? Which has less ionic character, which cannot dissociate 100%. Solubility product we won't give for NaCl like that. we will give for Al Cl3 like that. Okay, Al plus O4 twice or K2 Cr2 O7. Okay, like that we will have. Okay, so for salts we will have solubility product. So for a particular salt Ax and By kind of a salt, how this will dissociate? X A Y plus and Y B X minus. Okay, so KSP means what it is exactly? It is product of, okay, it is the product of concentration of cation and the concentration of anion in terms of molarity. In terms of what? Molarity. So these are also called solubility. What is this called? Solubility. Okay, so KSP you can write, KSP is the product of solubilities, product of solubilities of both cation and anion. What is solubility? Solubility is nothing but in terms of molarity we will take. Solubility means in terms of molarity. Solubility representation is S, capital S. Okay, so what is a KSP for this kind of reaction? Its solubility is its solubility is YS. Then what I can write KSP now? KSP is equals to X S power X and Y S power Y. Okay, KSP is a general formula either. But for this, you can write in one more way, this one. Concentration of A Y plus whole power X and concentration of B X minus whole power Y. Charge is always reverse. Y is the charge of A, X is the charge of B. What is the solubility? That depends on the number of moles here. X moles of A is there, so X is the solubility. So one mole of molarity means for X moles, X is. For one mole, molarity M. For X moles, X is. Okay, like that. S is the solubility here. Okay, then what you can write KSP therefore? KSP is equals to XS power X, YS power Y. So that what you can write KSP now therefore? You can write KSP is equals to X power X, Y power Y. So I write here. KSP is equals to, from here. KSP is equals to, what I'm doing? X power X, Y power Y, S power X plus Y. S power X, S power Y. So S power X plus Y. So this is a KSP general formula, please remember. In terms of, it's actually mole per liter. That means mole liter inverse. So this is a KSP. KSP is equals to X power X, Y power Y, S power X plus Y. Remember this. This is a very, very important. Okay, solubility. Suppose, what is the solubility? In terms of molarity we will take. And one more important thing. So, AB2, like this given. So, for AB2, here what you have? AB2 means X is 1. And Y is 2. Y is 2. So, for this kind of salt, what will be KSP? So, I said now here, 1 power 1, 2 power 2, because Y power 2. So, 2 moles, no? So, 2 power 2, S power 1 plus 2. So, KSP is equals to 4S cube. Suppose, like this given, Al2 SO4 thrice. So, 2, 3. That means, X is equals to 2, Y is equals to 3. Then what is KSP for this? KSP is equals to X is 2 now. So 2 power 2, 3 power 3, S power 2 plus 3. Mole per liter only. Mole square per liter square. Because this is S, that is S. Based on that, actually units depends on this value. Depends on this X and Y actually. So in terms of mole per liter we will take like that. Understood, sir? So very, very important. So this is about solubility product. Please write it down, KSP. This formula is important. If you know this, maximum you can do. Okay. So this is about what we call a solubility product. So as I said, this is very very important, and this is the last concept actually in this. Okay, so next, actually we have to enter into redox reactions. Okay sir, so very very important. What is that? Redox reactions. So based on KSP also we done many numericals, you can go through those please. Redox reactions. What is redox reaction? The reaction in which both oxidation and reduction takes place, that is called redox reaction. Got it sir everyone? Redox reaction means what? The reaction in which both oxidation and reduction takes place, that is called redox reaction. To understand this redox reaction chapter, most importantly we have to know what is that oxidation number concept or oxidation state concept. How to calculate oxidation state, everybody knows. What is that? From some rules. What are those? Hydrogen oxidation state is what? Before this, most important, I forgot. For any atom in its elemental state, oxidation state is equal to zero. What is the elemental state? How existing in nature. So examples are, can you give, suppose helium, neon, argon, xenon. These are existing state in the particular. Okay, so these are gases. For these, oxidation state will be zero. Like phosphorus, P4, S8. For this, oxidation state will be zero, because phosphorus exists as a tetraatomic. Sulfur exists as octatomic. We know this. Okay. Like halogens, fluorine or hydrogen, H2, F2, Cl2, Br2, I2, for all these oxidation state will be zero. Similar way for metals in their neutral state, like lithium or sodium or potassium or magnesium, or I don't know, that's why after potassium, magnesium, generally some metals I'm writing. Without charge, if they given, pure metals if they given, their oxidation states will be zero. Very very important. Okay, next, second point. Hydrogen exhibit two oxidation states. One is plus one and one is minus one. So it's a revision. That's why I'm just giving directly without giving what is the definition of oxidation state and all. You know all those things. Oxidation state means the formal charge exists on atom due to loss of electron or gain of electron or unequal sharing of electron. Due to loss of electron, positive oxidation state. Due to gain of electron, negative oxidation state. Due to unequal sharing, more electronegative atom gets negative charge, negative oxidation state. Less electronegative atom gets positive oxidation state. Electronegativity values I was given. So by using that, you can come to it. Hydrogen exhibit plus one with non-metals. Non-metals except boron, because boron is less electronegative than hydrogen. So hydrogen is a negative there. But more for the remaining all non-metals, you can say hydrogen exhibit plus one. Hydrogen exhibit minus one with what? With metals. With what? Metals like this. Okay, these are important points. And few more like halogen. Fluorine always minus one. Fluorine always minus one. And chlorine, bromine, iodine, they exhibit minus one. This is general oxidation state. Okay. Next, Mr. Remaining, what we call this chlorine, bromine, iodine also exhibit to one more like group number oxidation state. Group number oxidation state. And these halogens also have some group number -2 oxidation state. These halogens also have odd number of oxidation states, +1, +3, +5, +7 oxidation states, these halogens. With whom? With more electronegative atom, these halogens exhibit positive oxidation states also. This is actually group number oxidation state, means what? Halogens belongs to which group? 7A. So they exhibit 7A oxidation, 7 as a plus 7 as an oxidation state. Group number -2 means 7 -2 +5. So halogens, except fluorine, they exhibit positive oxidation states like this. Okay, so come to oxygen. How it exhibit oxidation state means, oxygen is the second most electronegative. Have you written? Please write it down on this. Pause the video, right? Okay. What I said? Yeah. Oxygen exhibit what? Different oxidation states. What is that? Oxide, peroxide, and superoxide actually. So in previous, just I said oxygen is the second most electronegative atom. So only with fluorine, oxygen exhibit positive oxidation state. Because you know this, oxygen electronegativity is 3.5, but fluorine is 4. No other atom has, except fluorine, no other atom has more electronegativity than oxygen. Certainly, oxygen exhibit that positive oxidation state only with fluorine. Remember, this is the most important. Next, oxygen example you want? Oxygen in OF2 and O2F2. OF2 means oxygen is a +2. In O2F2 means oxygen +1. To calculate oxidation state, for whom you are calculating oxidation state, let it be X. And halogen, I said, mainly fluorine, always -1. Two fluorines are there, so two. Each fluorine -1, I said in previous, -1. When the whole molecule is a neutral, then equal to 0 we have to take. If the whole species has some charge, that charge you have to equalize here. That is the most important thing. So X is equals to +2 here, in this way. Here O2F2 means 2x plus 2 into -1 is equals to 0, then 2x equals to +2, then x equals to +1. Like this we will have some oxidation states, very very important. Okay, so oxidation states to calculate, this was important. Yes, see, one more important thing is alkali metals always exhibit +1, always, anytime. Alkaline earth metals exhibit +2 always. Sir, about oxygen, now you said only these. No, I will give you a few more. I didn't forget. But you know that oxygen exhibit oxide, peroxide, superoxide. Those all I tell you. But this is general oxidation states. But before this, I will tell you general oxidation state of element up to 4A group is equals to group number. What group number? Plus group number. General oxidation state of element from 50A to 80. 50A to 80. From 5th A to 8th A, it is group number -8 oxidation state, general oxidation states. But as going down due to inert pair effect, I told you in previous, inert pair effect, due to inert pair effect, as going down, group number -2 oxidation state is more stable. So except 1A and 2A, all the remaining S and P block, because I am not talking about transition elements, because transition elements, oxidation states, we already discussed in second year chapter D and F, you can go through that. They exhibit many oxidation states, okay, more than one oxidation states, variable oxidation states. So here I am talking about oxidation states of S block and P block, means from 1A to 8A, total 8 groups I am talking. Alkali metals and alkaline earth metals, that's why I written before. Okay, alkali metals always its group number, alkaline earth metal always plus 2. But remaining from 3A to 8A, they exhibit like this, either group number or group number minus 8 generally. But as going down, every group element from 3A to 8A, they exhibit two oxidation states. One is group number minus 2 and one is group number. As going down, group number minus 2 oxidation state is more stable due to inert pair effect. So this is the most important thing you have to remember. Got it, sir, everyone? So this one. And now, as going down, I told you clearly. Now, oxygen, what kind of oxidation state that exhibit means? As the oxide, oxide means O minus 2, peroxide means O2 minus 2, superoxide, O2 minus, this is superoxide. Superoxide have odd number of electrons. Superoxide is a paramagnetic in nature. Color, because unpaired electron it have. How you said? O minus 2, oxygen 8 and minus 2, 10. O2, 16. O2 means 16, no? Each oxygen 8. Minus 2, 16 plus 2, minus means don't subtract, minus is the charge that is due to gain of electron, 2 electrons gain. So 16 plus 2, what do you have? 18. But here 16 plus 1, because minus, so here 17 electrons are there, it has having odd number of electrons. That's why superoxide having odd number of electrons and paramagnetic, important question. Okay, charge by knowing that you can say, example, if you want K2O, okay, K2O2 and KO2, see the difference. You can have oxide, peroxide and superoxide. As going down, we discussed in P block also, as going down due to inert pair effect in nitrogen family, oxygen family or whatever, and even boron family also, if you see, as going down, group number minus 2 is more stable. The concept is important. Okay, please have screenshot and write it, please. Now, we have all the, what we call the oxidation states, how to calculate. And one more important thing is, what is that? One more important thing. Yeah. How to calculate oxidation states, you know, you can practice. But like some ions, if you see, like NH4, always plus 1, always plus 1, okay, and some like water, NH3, okay, and some neutral, like CO, these all, CO means carbon monoxide, in carbonyl compounds also we use neutral ligands. So for these, oxidation state will be 0 for this whole molecule, I am saying. Sir, oxygen minus 2, no sir. Hydrogen plus 1, no sir. Don't say like this. Nitrogen minus 3, no sir. Nitrogen minus 3. Hydrogen plus 1. So total NH3 oxidation state of this, oxidation state of a total neutral molecule, I am saying. Why I am saying, you know, complex compounds we discussed. NiCO4 times what is the nickel oxidation state means X plus 4 into 0 is equals 0 and X is 0. Nickel oxidation state is 0. Like this we discussed in previous for all this. But some ions are there like sulfate SO4 minus 2, NO2 minus, NO3 minus, carbonate CO3 minus 2, bicarbonate HCO3 minus, bisulfate HSO3 minus, okay, you can write bisulfate HSO4 minus and cyanide minus, NC minus, like this you can write. Halogens always minus 1 with metals, I told you. Okay, so these all are ions you can remember. Phosphate, you can see PO3 minus 3 phosphate, you can write. So these all are very, very important and we have to understand all these things. Okay, so if you know this, now you can calculate oxidation states. But some examples like I3 minus, in these, what is individual iodine oxidation state? Average, if they ask, X, 3 iodines are 3X, equal to minus 1, you can write, equal to I3 minus. Okay, so 3X is equal to minus 1, then X equals to minus 1 by 3. Each iodine average oxidation state, if they ask, it is minus 1 by 3. But I3 minus, if they ask, you can write like this, I2 with I minus. So here I2 means zero oxidation state. I told you elemental state oxidation state is zero. I minus means minus 1. So minus 1 charge shared by 3 oxygens, sorry, 3 iodines, sorry. So each iodine oxidation state means minus 1 by 3. Average, if they ask, minus 1 by 3. Even you have 0 and minus 1 in options, average iodine oxidation state is how much, means minus 1 by 3. What is the iodine oxidation state, if they ask? Minus 1 by 3 option is there, along with the 0 and minus 1. Then you can select minus 1 by 3. Or all these 3 options given, minus 1 by 3, 0 and minus 1. And along with those 3, if they given all of the above, then all of the above is the answer, like that. Okay. Like that you can take. Next, you can have this kind, I think so, like in previous also I was given Br double bond O and double bond O, Br double bond O, double bond O, Br double bond O, double bond O, double bond O. What is the bromine oxidation state like this, they'll ask? Br3O8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What is the bromine oxidation state means? Two different oxidation states. Here bromine is plus 6, here minus 2, here minus 2, here minus 2. Only compound, even number. Here bromine is plus 4. Here bromine is again plus 6. Why, sir? Minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, minus 6. So this bromine has plus positive oxidation state. No? Terminal atoms and central atom oxidation states are always opposite. Remember. Each oxygen minus 2. Remember. Oxygen, if you see, oxygen as a double bond O, as a single bond OH, these two, minus 2 oxidation state. Double bonded oxidation state, always minus 2, remember. So in this way you can have. Do you know this? And tricarbene, like this, C3O2, double bond C, double bond O, like this, sorry, C3, double bond C, double bond O. C3O2. Okay, so in this, what is the carbon oxidation state? This carbon is plus 2, but this carbon is 0, but this carbon is plus 2 again, because oxygen minus 2, this oxygen minus 2, but central carbon oxidation state is 0. So if this is the example, what is the example we call? C3O2. Okay, so very, very important, this kind of example, you know. Chromium pentoxide, crown like structure, those also you know. So there also chromium oxidation states we will take. So oxidation state is important concept actually. You can go through that once. Okay. So you have like this, Cr double bond O and O like this. O, CrO5. Crown like structure. If you calculate normally like x plus 5 into minus 1 is equal to 0, then x equal to plus 5. This is not correct. So here oxygen is minus 2, this is minus 1, this is minus 1, or minus 1 and minus 1. So minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 4, oxygen is minus 2, total minus 6. So this chromium is plus 6 oxidation state. Like this we can have oxidation states, very, very important. And to have oxidation states for sulfur, and all in oxoacids I was given, simple tricks also I was given, how to remember their skeletal structures I was given. Okay, so those are very, very important. So redox reactions, in this, if you know oxidation states, most of the concepts you can understand easily. So this what I am trying to tell you. Okay, so next actually you have in this how to balance the redox reaction and all, you have oxidation number method and that ion electron method you have. Actually I done some videos also, so those also if you want personally I will send you, but you ask me because we have those in previous, because based on that we won't have any questions mostly. Okay, so how they'll ask and how to answer, I was done one more video previously, so that I will send you actually. If you want personally you ask me, I'll send. Okay, that is always important. And afterwards, you know, types of redox reactions I was given, mainly what combination reaction, dissociation reaction, okay, and one more thing, disproportionation, comproportionation, okay, and all combustion reactions are combination reactions. I told you all those things, but some are CaCO3 dissociation happening, CaCO3 equilibrium, CaO plus CO2. In this, actually it is dissociation reaction, CaCO3 equilibrium, CaO plus CO2. But here calcium plus 2, carbonate CO3 minus 2, but here carbon plus 4, here carbon plus 4, here calcium plus 2, here oxygen however same, here minus 2, here also minus 2. So it's dissociation reaction, but it is not a redox reaction. How we call redox reaction? Suppose a particular reaction happened by changing in particular oxidation states of atom, then we call that as any redox reaction. Suppose combustion reaction, if you see CH4 plus 2O2 and gives rise to CO2 plus 2H2O, like this. Okay, this is combustion reaction as well as what we call combination reaction, as well as this is a redox reaction. First of all, why? Here carbon is carbon electronegativity 2.5, hydrogen is 2.1, so carbon is more electronegative, so carbon is minus 4, but here carbon is plus 4. Here oxygen as O2 it is 0, but here or here oxygen is minus 2, of course here also oxygen minus 2. Hydrogen here plus 1, here also plus 1. So hydrogen we have no need to consider. So this is a redox reaction. Why oxygen here 0? Elemental state. Minus 4 became plus 4. If oxidation state increase, that is oxidation. If oxidation state decrease, that is reduction. 0 big or minus 2? 0 is big, minus 2 is less. So oxidation state of oxygen, what happened? Decreased. So that is reduction. Like you have a disproportionation reaction. P4 gives rise to H2PO2 minus plus PH3. Okay, so here phosphorus is 0, but here phosphorus is plus 2 minus 4, so minus 2, so here plus 1 you have. Here phosphorus is minus 3. Understanding H2PO2 minus phosphorus X plus 2 hydrogens, 2 into plus 1 plus 2 into minus 2 is equal to minus 1, then X equal to plus 1 you will have. Okay, so one particular substance is converting to 2, one is converting to 2. Okay, one particular substance is only undergoing both oxidation and reduction, then that reaction is called disproportionation. This is called disproportionation reaction. I was given types of redox reactions. Please go through that. Still, if you have doubts, please ask me. This is what disproportionation reaction. Understanding? I'll give you one example. It's what kind of reaction can be. H2O2 on dissociation, it will give H2O plus O2. It is dissociation reaction, redox reaction only. Because hydrogen peroxide means oxygen minus 1. Water means oxygen minus 2. Here, oxygen 0. Okay, it's a dissociation reaction. At the same time, it is also disproportionation reaction. Why? Because minus 1 becomes 0, minus 2, minus 1 becomes 0. So
So minus 1 become minus 2, reduction. Reduction, how to identify? Reduce in oxidation state. RR. Reduce in oxidation state. Minus 1 becomes 0. Increase in oxidation state. Increase in oxidation state. That is what? Oxidation. Okay? So this is about a disproportionation. Disproportionation, opposite reaction is what? Comproportionation reaction. So please have a screenshot. Okay. What is the comproportionation reaction? See, what is the disproportionation reaction? 1 converted to 2 is a disproportionation. Now 2 is converting to 1. How? Like AG plus AG is converting to, okay, converting to AG plus 2 or AG plus 2 and converting to AG plus 2AG plus, like this kind of reaction. 2 converted to 1. Only silver? Here silver oxidation state is plus 2, here silver is 0, here silver is plus 1. So 2 into plus 1, don't consider, these are just for balancing. Only charge you have to consider. Plus 2 become plus 1 is 1, 0 converted to plus 1 is 1. 0 converted to plus 1, oxidation. Plus 2 become plus 1, reduce in oxidation state. So this is reduction. So two different oxidation states convert to one kind of oxidation state, that is called comproportionation. This is example for comproportionation reaction. Please write it down. And I will give you one example. Okay. And I will send one more video. How to balance redox reactions. Those also you watch whenever you free. I won't say after this video only, I won't say. Okay. I will give you that relaxation. So please watch this carefully. Try to understand everything. And if you have doubts, and please ask.